A reward is something we give someone to acknowledge something that they have done well. Whether or not a reward is rewarding depends on whether the person receiving the reward sees it as desired. Often in schools, rewards are selected by the adults and may not be appealing to students. I gave my 4-year-old a lollipop because she was calm and well-behaved in the supermarket. This is rewarding to my 4-year-old because she loves lollipops. My boss gives me a lollipop for arriving on time. This is not rewarding because I don't like lollipops. I see getting one as childish and would have arrived on time anyway. We say that something is reinforcing when it results in a repetition of a behaviour. For example, if you post a cat video on social media, it gets lots of likes and you post more cat videos. Then the likes have been reinforcing. Rewards may or may not be reinforcing to an individual, depending on whether or not they see the reward as desirable. Rewards only work when they are valued by students and when they are delivered contingent on behaviour. It's important that rewards consider context and culture and our knowledge of students. Rewards do not work if we have not established positive relationships with students or taught them how to meet our expectations. Rewards also will not work if students do not value them or if we use them to try and force compliance. It's not okay to use rewards in a controlling way or to use a basic human right such as access to recess as a reward. Remember also that some students may experience rewards differently because of their prior experiences, so we need to be flexible in our use of rewards. Teachers may worry that rewards will decrease motivation. The fear is that by providing extrinsic rewards, students will never become intrinsically motivated. Studies have shown that rewards can indeed decrease motivation for some tasks, but only if we reward students for doing things they like and would do anyway, a bit like the lollipop for arriving on time example. So, rewarding students for reading if they already like reading could result in a decrease in reading behaviour. However, rewarding students for tasks they find difficult or uninteresting does not harm motivation, and rewards will actually encourage students to have a go. Better still, once students have experienced some success, they are more likely to continue the behaviour without a reward because the experience of success becomes its own reward.